Vegetable plants generally require much higher fertility than is usually available in most soils. As we have bred vegetables over the centuries to produce large yields when the soil fertility is high. Most of the gardens that we manage as part of this Red Gardens project rely primarily on compost, with a few amendments, to build and replenish this soil fertility. The extensive garden, which is based on the advice of Steve Solomon, uses a reasonable amount of compost to feed the soil each year, but focuses on the use of a DIY mix of materials to feed the plants. Steve refers to this mix as complete organic fertilizer, or COF, and recommends that it starts with a substantial amount of seed meal, or seed cake, which is the remains of the seeds grown for oil, such as rapeseed, after the oil has been pressed out of them. This dry, leftover material is often used as an animal feed, as it still contains a significant amount of nutrients, and is especially high in protein, which when decomposed by soil organisms can provide a convenient supply of nitrogen for plants. I have only been able to get seed meal on a few occasions in the past, as it just doesn't seem to be used as a common animal feed around here. So, in preparation for this season, I have been searching for a suitable substitute, which is more readily available in this area, in order to ensure that I'm able to provide a substantial amount of nitrogen for the plants in this garden. I think the approach that Steve has taken with this complete organic fertilizer is quite interesting. It is a mix of materials that can be adjusted so that it contains a balanced supply of all of the nutrients that a plant would need, from the larger quantities of nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and calcium, right through to the trace elements. And the proportions of the different ingredients can be adjusted to suit the type of soil, and to slowly start to balance out any deficiencies or excesses that there might be in that soil. Getting all of the ingredients took a bit of work and shopping around, and I've tended to buy larger quantities that are a significant investment up front, but much cheaper in the long run. I have enough of some of these ingredients to last years, if not decades, or at least more than enough to share with friends and neighbors. Steve's recipe has everything worked out in easy to measure volumes, and once mixed together, it produces a stable, dry material that is easy to store and easy to spread onto the gardens when needed. Used in addition to a reasonable amount of compost, it is supposed to provide an abundance of the balance of nutrients that the vegetable plants need to grow quickly. But the main ingredient, seed meal, which is added to provide a convenient source of nitrogen, has been quite difficult to get. I was able to get a few bags of seed meal a number of years ago from a farmer who grew organic rapeseed for producing oil, but it definitely wasn't a convenient option, and none of the producers I contacted in the past few years were able to provide me with any seed meal. So I've been using chicken manure pellets as a source of nitrogen instead. The chicken manure pellets have been my usual form of additional fertility for use in a few of the gardens, and was a convenient substitute for the seed meal in providing a reasonable amount of nitrogen, as well as phosphorus, potassium, and other nutrients. And I've been able to grow a lot of good quality vegetables with this mix, but I've wanted to try to find a replacement that had more in common with the seed meal. One of the key reasons that Steve Solomon recommends the use of seed meal is that it is commonly available in animal feed suppliers in many parts of the world, but not here in Ireland, it seems. Where it is available, a large bag can apparently be purchased at a reasonable cost and used as a basis of fertility in the vegetable garden. And I think this idea is really quite interesting, that a convenient and inexpensive fertilizer for the vegetable plants in our gardens can be found in the stores that are supplying feed for livestock, horses, and other animals. Essentially, whatever can be used to feed animals can be used to feed plants, or more accurately, it can be added to the soil where it is consumed by the worms and other soil organisms, and the released nutrients are then available to be picked up by the plant roots. I am based in a landscape dominated by dairy and beef farms, with a few poultry and pig operations, and with a lot of people keeping horses. So naturally, there are places in local towns where different kinds of feed can be purchased. And I went looking for a suitable substitute for seed meal, and I wanted something that had similar characteristics. It needed to contain a fair amount of nitrogen, but was minimally processed without a lot of unknown additives, was widely available and preferably from local sources, and it would be great if it was the byproduct or waste product of some other industry or process. But I could not find anything that satisfied all these criteria. Most of the feed was a mix of several different ingredients, often containing substantial amounts of soya beans, which was imported from Argentina, Brazil, and the USA, which I definitely wanted to stay away from. And almost all of it was processed into a pellet or kibble form with a range of different ingredients, with the aim of adjusting that feed to better meet the requirements of different animals at different stages of their development and being raised for different purposes. And it seemed that only rolled barley and rolled oats, sold as a simple feed for horses, was the closest to what I was looking for. I think any of these other types of feed supplies could be used in the gardens, if that's all I could get, or if I had a few bags lying around. And it would be interesting to try if I wasn't concerned about the origin of some of the ingredients. For use in the vegetable gardens, it's the protein content that is listed on the side of each bag that is a key thing to look for, as the higher the protein content, the more nitrogen will eventually be made available for the plants. This is one of the many things that I learned from Steve Solomon, that essentially protein is nitrogen, or more accurately, nitrogen is a key component of all proteins. From the standpoint of the garden, the nitrogen is simply stored in a more complex molecule of proteins and amino acids, which will be consumed by the soil organisms when it is added to the soil, and the nitrogen will then be released in a form that can be absorbed by the plants. Apparently, the main way protein content is typically determined in feeds like this is to measure the nitrogen content and multiply that by 6.25 to get an approximation of the protein content. So we can do the reverse, divide the listed protein content by 6.25 to get an approximate percentage of nitrogen that we would expect to be made available. This is one of the reasons that Steve Solomon recommends seed meal, as it is so high in protein, often exceeding 30%, which would translate to about 5% nitrogen. The recipe for COF lists everything in volumes required to cover a certain area. But because the other ingredients have different densities and protein content, I use the typical density of seed meal to calculate that about 100 grams of nitrogen would be added to each batch of COF. So that is the very approximate target of the amount of nitrogen that I'm looking for in each batch. The rolled oats from my local supplier are listed as having 9% protein, which would translate to almost 1.5% nitrogen. Dividing the 100 grams of nitrogen that I'm looking for by 1.5%, this works out at just under 7 kilograms of oats, which is conveniently about one-third of a 20 kilogram bag of rolled oats per batch of COF. And with the layout of the extensive garden into 8 beds, each of which is about the size that Steve recommends applying a batch of COF to, I would need 8 batches in total. So 3 of the 20 kilogram bags of rolled oats would be enough to supply the full garden with a generous amount of nitrogen at the beginning of the growing season, with enough left over for another batch of COF, which could be used to side dress the plants during the growing season. These 3 bags of rolled oats cost me just over 20 euro, which is a reasonable amount compared to the 300 to 400 kilograms of vegetables that I could grow in this garden in one season. And rolled barley would be similar. Some of the other types of feed would be cheaper as a source of nitrogen, and it is possible to get nitrogen from a lot of other sources that are less expensive and potentially even free. But there are usually issues and potential problems with all of them. And it is interesting that the rolled oats are approximately the same price as the chicken manure pellets that I have been using, at least when comparing the amount of nitrogen that they contain. I like that these oats are minimally processed, simply rolled to crush the seeds, which will make them much faster to decompose in the soil and prevent them from sprouting. I also like that they don't contain any other additives, and that they come from a processing facility that is not so far away, so transportation will not be much of an issue. And it's likely that these oats were grown in farms in the same region, or at least in Ireland, though that's not guaranteed. And these bags of rolled oats are available in seed suppliers throughout the country. So, rolled oats have a reasonable amount of nitrogen, are minimally processed, don't contain additives or ingredients that I would rather stay away from, are widely available, and from a relatively local source. But they are not a byproduct or waste product from another industry or process. Unlike the chicken manure pellets, which are made from the waste streams of large-scale facilities that raise chickens, these oats are grown specifically for feeding horses and humans. And this is the key issue that I have with using oats directly as a source of fertility in the soil. I like the idea that waste byproducts that would otherwise need to be disposed of can be used in the gardens as a source of organic matter and fertility. For those of us who don't have access to a convenient supply of uncontaminated manure and don't have the capacity to produce the abundant quantities of high-quality compost that our vegetable gardens would require, buying in fertility and organic matter is a reasonable alternative. And there are lots of possibilities, though they all have issues. For example, with the chicken manure pellets that I've been using, I wonder about the energy and infrastructure needed to dry the manure and process them into the pellets. I have also bought in another type of fertility in a pellet form that is higher in nitrogen and perhaps more suitable as an ingredient for the COF, but it is processed and packaged far away from where I'm located. And like many of the other forms of concentrated fertility that we could buy in for our gardens, these pellets make use of the waste streams that come from large-scale industrial facilities that process livestock, something that an increasing number of people want to stay away from for a variety of reasons. I would rather use seed meal if I could get it conveniently, but the rolled oats seem like a decent replacement to try this season, despite reservations that I have about burying food in the soil. But this is an interesting possible benefit of using ingredients like seed meal and rolled oats, as they contain a lot more than just nitrogen. And with the quantities that I will be adding to the soil, this will be a significant amount of very rich organic matter and other nutrients for the soil organisms. And I would not be surprised if this results in a significant increase in the number of worms in the soil. So, in a way, using these rolled oats as part of the complete organic fertilizer mix will be feeding the soil as well as feeding the plants.